Hello YouTubers, Dagamon here. In this video I'm going to benchmark Shadow of War on a single GTX 1070 paired with an Intel Core i7-860. The video will be recorded on an external recorder as always, so what you will see will be pure performance. The CPU is overclocked to 4 GHz, we will see that in game and in MSI Afterburner more clearly later on. 12 GB of system RAM, and the graphics card is a GTX 1070 made by KFA2. It is the EX model, latest Nvidia driver installed and also overclocked in order to boost at 2 GHz. Now for this video I'm going to do two benchmarks with the built-in benchmarking tool of the game and a custom gameplay session, of course, which I will benchmark with OCAT. And for this benchmark, we will see comparisons with FLAT on with some of my previous runs. So let's launch the game and let's see if the Core i7-860 will be limiting the GTX 1070, and if so, how much. Okay, the game has loaded. Let's go to the options first. I'm going to use again the same settings as I have used on all my GTX 1070 and 970 videos, meaning 1080p resolution, borderless display mode, no vertical sync of course. And for the first run I'm going to use the ultra preset with whatever that means for all the settings you see here. Let's see the built-in benchmark at ultra first. I was getting 95 frames per second on the Core i5-8600K. Let's see if the Core i7-860 will score close to it or lower, or no, higher is not possible. So we are getting 87 frames per second, down from 95 frames per second that we were getting for the Coffee Lake system. Quite interesting. We did see the GPU load drop at some point. In any case, let's go to the options again. I'm going to set the very high preset, apply. Very high, okay, and let's see what the very high preset can do for us. I was getting 105 frames per second for the very high on the Coffee Lake system. I'm getting 95 frames per second now. I was getting 105 for the Coffee Lake system, 10 frames per second down. A considerable difference, but still a very playable performance. And now let's switch the graphics back to Ultra preset and move on. Okay, move on to the in-game benchmark, the gameplay benchmark, which is of course more important.
Front lines and beyond. The raiding parties will destabilize Sauron's forces.
Okay, the game has loaded. Very good. I'm starting the benchmark. As always, I'm not going to fight just yet.
Come back, man, Phil. He's right here.
Can't have run out of orcs in the city.
There are a few left, but we're hunting one in particular, the last bodyguard of the war chief leading the siege.
I think we're after the same orc. And the way to a war chief is through his bodyguards.
You sound like you've had some experience in this.
I've had enough.
I'll follow your lead.
You won't see me near a descent. This place will drive you mad.
For Gondor.
I was made to be a war chief and have 50 orcs at my command. No, 40 orcs.
Did you hear that?
This is from Minas Ethel. Join your fallen brothers.
Someone's sneaking about. Did I just hear something?
Still won't save you lot from the blade.
Okay, I'm ending the benchmark. The game ran quite nicely in game, of course. We will see the performance result in a moment. For now, let me do some quick calculations regarding the built-in benchmark. Yes, it was 105 for the very high on the 1070 with the Coffee Lake, 95 for the Linfield, 11% performance difference, and from 95 for the Coffee Lake at Ultra, we went to 87 for the Linfield, 9% performance difference. Not too bad. Not too bad for the old CPU. We can see the two built-in runs here and here. This is that the ultra preset and this one at very high, we see the same dip in the performance in both runs when many NPCs appear on screen. The frame rate drops. The frame times seem to be okay for the built-in benchmark. Now, as for the in-game benchmark, we have decent performance, but some big spikes did appear at some points. Overall, I do not see something consistently bad for the frame times, but we will see what the analysis of FLAT will show us. It does not seem to be severely GPU limited, however, GPU usage seems to be maxed out throughout the run. The CPU usage in game seems to be medium. We have overall CPU usage at 40%. Quite a lot of thread switching must be going on. Main thread seems to be on CPU number 4. Not bad, not great either. The CPU temps are again very good. GPU temps very decent. 4.8 GB of RAM usage. 2 GHz throughout the run for the GTX 1070, that is. The video RAM usage is crazy at 7.9 GB. We have been warned from the settings, however. The built-in benchmark went to 8.1 GB and the very high for the Ultra, that is, and for the very high it was only 4 GB. We see a considerable shift in video RAM requirements from one setting to the next, and it was consistent at close to 8 GB for in-game, 4 GHz for the CPU clock. And now let's move to the very important measurements of FLAT. I'm going to open the GTX 1070 with the i7-860 first. Oh, wait a minute, I am on my network drive, so let's open the i5-8600K first. The Shadow of War benchmark is this one. Yes, I don't have any other Shadow of War benchmark on this system. Very good. And now let's move on to the local system with the GTX 1070 and the i7-860. This is the benchmark I just did. 1070 and 860, just so I remember it. And while I am here, I'm also going to open the GTX 970 with the i7-860 to see the difference of the video card. I'm pretty sure, yes, 970, 860, this is the one. It was very low at 38 frames per second indeed. So let me make this a green one, this a red one, and this one a blue one. Very good. Red, my friend, not pink. 85, 86 frames per second for the Core i7-860, 90 frames per second for the Coffee Lake. However, the Coffee Lake has much better comparable at 78 frames per second. I dropped it to 65 for the Linfield due to the stuttering. The variability seems to be the same. I'm afraid these spikes we saw during the run of the Linfield affected the overall performance, so we may be looking at somewhat unfair comparable. We do have these spikes that occurred, however, the rest of the stuttering, as you can see, is very good. The performance is very solid. Let me move into 60 milliseconds to see all that clearly. There we are. A little more stuttering at the beginning of the run, where the engine is probably doing more stuff. This is the part where the stutters appear. For the Coffee Lake, as you can see, these readings were much, much better. We do not have these big spikes. These are probably loading times that halted the game engine, and the Coffee Lake does not have this problem because it is a much faster CPU. It does have quite better frame times, as you can see. This is undisputed. And we can see here that the same spikes appeared on the GTX 970 run on the Core i7-860, so this should be taken into consideration. It is something locally that is affecting these spikes. The 970 spikes were far worse, of course. Let's move to the time spent beyond 16.7 milliseconds, which was 0.43%. Sorry. 0.09% for the Coffee Lake system. The differences are not that big, as you can see. The GTX 970 is showing us a very different result, of course. So the game is primarily GPU limited. There is no disputing that. The histogram of the frame times shows us most frame times below 15 milliseconds. So we have very good performance, but the big spikes that occurred during the run pushed the histogram data to the left of the chart. It is much better, of course, for the Coffee Lake system. Everything is even below 13 milliseconds, and on top of that, we do not have the huge spikes that affected the run. The GTX 970, of course, is a lot worse, with much worse histogram for its frame times, a lot more delays. Let's see the three runs side by side. The GTX 970 was a little shorter, however, the two runs of the GTX 1070 are much, much closer together. Almost at sync. It is a dynamic game, of course, and some minor differences are normal to occur. However, we can see that the two runs are very close together. The Coffee Lake has a thinner outline for its frame times in the blue, but the Core i7-860 also has very good frame times after a while. Except, of course, these big spikes that seem to be unavoidable for this specific system. It could be from the hard drive, I'm not sure. I'm not sure at all. We will see if the same spikes will appear when the Core i5-2500K gets installed in this system. And we will see how it will fare with these spikes, or if they are due to the CPU decompressing stuff and losing some frames. Overall, the average is very close, as you can see. It is only the maximum that is severely affected on the Core i7-860. The three frame rates side by side. again we can see in the blue the Core i5-8600K is a little faster, but not that much faster. They are overlapping with the Core i7-860 all the time. Overall, the gaming experience is very good, don't get me wrong. Min, max and averages, we can see the minimum has been affected here on the Core i7-860. The average is not very different, but what I really want to see is the lows. The 0.1% lows are really affected in a very bad way. Even so, however, just by adding the GTX 1070 on the Core i7-860, we are getting a hugely better performance compared to the GTX 970. And I will do my calculations right away. We only have 4.6%, 4.7% difference for the average. So the gaming experience should not be really that much difference. The 1% lows are also quite close, only 12% difference. However, the 0.1% lows have received a major strike on the Core i7-860, and we have a 66 performance difference here. But again, this reading may not be very fair for the Core i7-860. It could be attributed to something else and not the CPU power, which seems to be adequate otherwise in order to run the game very nicely. The three variability and stuttering graphs, very good variability and stuttering for the Coffee Lake system, not bad variability for the Core i7-860, however the stuttering is affected by the big spikes we saw earlier. The percentiles is another very important graph which can really show us that the runs are indeed very much very close together. The Coffee Lake system is only a tiny bit faster, less than half a millisecond I think. So overall we have very good runs for both GTX 1070 benchmarks. The 970 is having a severe problem, and this exactly shows us how GPU limited the games actually is, mostly GPU limited. Time spent beyond chart does not help. And lastly, the three comparables. The GTX 1070 drops to 65 due to the spikes we saw during the run. I believe this reading to be a little unfair for the Core i7-860. The system performed really very well for this game. These are due to calculations by FLAT, of course, and the big spikes that were appearing during the run affected these charts. Not a bad run, still above 60 frames per second for the Core i7-860, still very good performance, which brings us to the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching, stay tuned for more, take care.